My name is Inonge Wina. I come from Zambia and I'm the minister in charge of gender and child development. I entered politics in 2011. I was elected a member of parliament from one of the rural constituencies in Zambia. And upon election, I was appointed by my president as Minister for Chiefs and Traditional Affairs. I was at that ministry for 1 year to set the groundwork and to organize structures for the ministry. After that, I was transferred to the Ministry of Gender and Child Development. The challenges we have in Zambia in the political arena is that there are very few women politicians. Rather, there are many women politicians, but very few representatives in parliament and in local councils. For example, we have a parliament of 158 representatives, and only 20 are women. And we have a cabinet of 20, and only 4 are women. So it shows you that we have a lot of work to do in order to increase the numbers of women in parliament. Some of the reasons that are becoming a barrier to women's participation in politics is lack of resources. Political environment is very competitive, and the women require money to participate in those elections. Secondly, the cultural norms and practices are still a barrier to women's participation in politics. Family issues, like having small children, is another barrier that stops a lot of women from entering the political arena. So you can see that there are lots and lots of challenges. But those women who are determined, they go ahead and participate. Again, we need to grow the young generation to appreciate politics. And for the women to realize that if they are not participants in the political process, they will not be able to be there where decisions are made. And it's very important for the women to have their decisions, their concerns, their aspirations known by the political leaders, including women political leaders. So it shows you that it's important for women to be political activists, to be in politics, because they'll address issues which concern them, basically, for themselves, for their families, for the communities where they live.